Dear viewers, I welcome you to the class number 3 of convection. First convection, especially. So now, before entering into class number 3, I would like to summarize the points of class number 2, which is very much necessary to analyze this thermal boundary layer. So in class number 2, we have discussed about velocity boundary layers. And while explaining about this velocity boundary layer, I have also mentioned about this Newton's law of viscosity, meaning of that viscosity, Reynolds number, significance of the Reynolds number, how does it affects the type of flow, relationship between the Reynolds number and the type of flow, reason for this viscosity, why does viscosity reduces the velocity because of this viscous force and the friction, Newton's law of viscosity, where we got to know that shear stress of the fluid will be proportional to the velocity gradient, meaning of this word gradient. These are all the things that we have studied in class number 2. Fine. So now, let us summarize all these points. We have studied this, but let us summarize in this sense, the conclusions that you should be knowing after studying this velocity boundary layer. Like, I can put it up in few of the points. So we had three different regions called as laminar, transition and turbulent flow, right? Velocity at that plate will be zero, and at a distance called as infinity we have a maximum velocity, and here it is called as free stream flow of the fluid. Over here is called as free stream, and the corresponding velocity is free stream velocity. The word infinity doesn't mean that it goes above the Earth's atmosphere, it crosses the skies, it goes to the universe. It's not like that. It starts from the point where we'll get the velocity of the fluid, velocity of the flow, much more equal to the velocity with which the air is being blown. If those two values are almost equal, then I can call that one as infinite distance. That's it. Okay, so now let me continue. Laminar, transition, turbulent flow. Here, at the point where fluid is just above this flat plate, at that point velocity will be zero. So the reason for that velocity to be zero at the surface of the flat plate is the friction between the flat plate and the fluid, right? Because of the friction, you can imagine a layer of a fluid which has been stuck to this plate. It appears to be stuck. It doesn't move at all. Fine. So since it is stuck, we can take that as a conduction mode of heat transfer that we'll discuss in thermal boundary layer. Fine. Later, the velocity goes on increasing. As the inertial force increases by Reynolds number, velocity goes on in Reynolds number increase. Thus, we'll get a flow transmission of flow from laminar to transition state and from transition to turbulent. It all depends on velocity, which in turn depends on these forces, Reynolds number. Fine. And now this is the thickness, which was called as delta, which was defining as the layer, a boundary. So this black ink, it was called as velocity boundary layer. Until this thickness delta, till delta, we had dv by dy, which was noticeable in the sense, is not like negligible, noticeable, or I can say we'll get some sufficient value, we'll get sufficient number, the value will, you'll get something like enough value, a bigger number you'll get. That means you will be able to find, you'll be able to notice, you'll be able to see the change in this velocity with respect to the distance y, that is dv by dy. Fine. After this, even if the there is increase in y, there is no much changes in velocity. Okay, that's what I mean. So now, from this, we can also conclude that from Newton's law of viscosity, tau is proportional to dv by dy, and this mu is proportional to constant. So you can refer here, after this point, this term it will almost reach us to zero. That is negligible. That means there is no shear stress after this boundary layer. No, matlab, it is not like nil. The effect of the shear stress on this flow is negligible. That's what it means. It is not exactly zero. It is negligible. But within this boundary layer, up to this thickness called as delta, we have a shear stress, effect of shear stress to a maximum extent on the flow. So these are all the conclusions that you can make from class number 2. Now let us continue to class number 3. Okay, in this class number 3, I'll take the few of the concepts from class number 2 directly, saying that we have laminar transition turbulent flow. This is the leading edge and the trailing edge. Fine. Then it was delta, which was called as velocity boundary layer, and here I have delta T. So this delta T is thickness of the thermal boundary layer. Fine. Their velocity was minimum in the sense it was zero exactly at the surface of the plate because of conduction. And I told we'll discuss this point in thermal boundary layer. So what is that in the sense? At y equals zero. So this is the y axis. And here I have x axis. At y equals 0, I can say the mode of heat transfer is conduction. Okay, conduction in the sense you need to imagine one thin layer of fluid above the plate which is stuck to the plate. Stuck in the sense something like you can imagine you have put some adhesive, you have make that layer to stick to the surface. Such a layer you need to imagine, because velocity is zero, it is stationary. So there we have a conduction mode of heat transfer. So now that layer will try to be at thermal equilibrium with the surface temperature of this plate. So plate is at some temperature called as TS, this plate's surface temperature, and over here we have V infinity. So let this be the surrounding temperature, T infinity. Fine. So now, since it is by conduction, I can use Fourier's law of conduction, which says Q is equal to minus K A into dT by dx, right? So applying the same law over here, I can say Q by A equals minus K of the fluid whichever is flowing over this plate, say K of a fluid into dou T, change of the temperature along this y direction only for that one thin layer. So dou T by dou y it is, not along x, it is along y. Fine. This is fluid. Okay, now why the temperature is maximum here in the sense, you need to apply thermodynamic zeroth law, which says that the fluid tries to reach the temperature of its surrounding. Fine. That means in technical language I can say it reaches to the thermodynamic equilibrium always, and now the surface temperature TS is more compared to T infinity. You need to imagine a hot surface, and hence the fluid tries to come in thermodynamic equilibrium with the plate. So the plate temperature and the fluid layer temperature, which is just above the surface, which is stuck to the surface, is one of the same. Likewise, you can imagine. Okay, but again, it cannot be same throughout the distance y. There will be some particular thickness up to which it is same. Again, later we will be getting a temperature difference for one layer to the another layer, as a result of which there is a heat transfer. Fine. So this is the case. And here, it was delta in case of velocity boundary layer, where we had dv by dt, which was noticeable. Delta, where dv by dy was noticeable. And here, till a distance called as delta t, I'll get dou t by dou y, or as dt by dy for throughout distance, which is noticeable, which has some value. Up to that particular distance, I will be taking a layer. Thickness of the layer is called as delta t, that is thermal boundary layer thickness. Fine. After that, you don't find a noticeable change in that temperature gradient. Fine. In a single statement, I can say
way up to the point wherever you get dt by dy as noticeable. Till that point, you can imagine a boundary layer, which is nothing but thermal boundary layer. And the point up to which you will get noticeable dv by dy, that is the point through which you can imagine a boundary layer called as velocity boundary layer. Fine. So dv by dy, if it is noticeable, it is delta. Likewise, if dt by dy, if it is noticeable, I have delta t. So delta t is that way dt by dy is noticeable. Okay, then coming to the next point, temperature is maximum, so it goes on decreasing, and there will be one particular layer which will be in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding temperature. Obviously, it has to be. So now between that topmost layer and this bottom layer, there is a temperature difference because of which heat is being flown, and this flow of heat is nothing but a convection. So we have convection mode of heat transfer also. This is the major mode of heat transfer. Where can you imagine this? After y equals 0. As y value increases, this convection mode of heat transfer you can imagine. So now here, this is governed by Newton's law of cooling, which says Q equals HEA into TS minus T infinity, right? So now here also we'll take a heat flux Q by A, H into TS minus T infinity. Okay, so now the concept here you need to understand is, this is the heat flux which is being conducted by the plate, and this is the heat flux which is being convected to the fluid. Now these two should be same. Okay, as long as we are studying steady state condition, these two should be same. So I can say from these two equations, H into TS minus T infinity should be equal to minus k of that fluid, this is the property of the fluid, into dou t by dou y at y equals 0 divided by this term H. I have written same thing, into TS minus T infinity, H into TS minus T infinity should be equal to this term, because these LHS are equal, so RHS will be equal. So now here, concentrate here, it is thermodynamic property for the fluid which is called as conductivity, right? Thermal conductivity of a material is K. This is the property of fluid, but H is not at all a property of fluid. Okay, so this H depends on this K. How? What is the thing that you need to analyze? Concentrate here again. If K value is more, conductivity will be more throughout the plate and also from the plate to the first layer, right? So if conductivity is more, you will get a very higher temperature. As soon as you apply heat, you will get a higher temperatures. Since there is a temperature difference, you will get much more temperature difference between the surface and the surroundings, so H will increase. If temperature is less, H will become less. Okay, if temperature difference is less, coefficient of that heat transfer will also be less, remember. So this H depends on the process, not on the fluid. What term of the fluid that you use, it always depends on this temperature. It always depends on the heat flux. Okay, so now here, since we are speaking about H, we need to also speak about the concept called as local convection coefficient and average convection coefficient. So what is that local and what is that average? In the sense, to understand that, you can imagine a plate of any two-dimensional or three-dimensional plate where it has some thickness, it has some length and breadth. That means a 3D diagram you need to imagine. See, this is the plate which you are imagining. Fine. So on the surface, you can imagine a small elemental area at a distance of x. So this is dx. So now, if this small elemental area is allowed for convection heat transfer coefficient, say Hx, For the small elemental area, I will say Qx equals Hx into area of that elemental area element into surface temperature and surrounding temperature, right? For entire thing, if I want, I need to integrate it, saying that it is from x equals to 0 up to the total value of length L, right? For this total distance, similarly over here, or else you can also say it is x, since we are taking x. That means I will get total heat transfer coefficient H. This is the average value. And if I take H at a particular region, it is local heat transfer coefficient. Now come back to the concept. This local heat transfer coefficient, I said it depends on the temperature. Now as soon as the convection begins here, the temperature goes on reducing, right? As X increases, temperature also decreases from this leading edge to the trailing edge. Since temperature is less, rate of heat transfer will be less. Since rate of heat transfer is less, I can say H will also be less here. If the rate of heat transfer is less, H is also decreasing. That means the value of Qx and Hx, it decreases with increase in X because temperature is decreasing. Fine. And also, it will decrease with respect to Y, because we have a temperature difference. So everything put together, see, X is being increased, local convection coefficient will be decreasing. Heat transfer coefficient by convection, the local value goes on decreasing. The local in the sense, it is dependent on X. At some particular point, if I am taking coefficient, it is called as local. If I am taking that coefficient for throughout the plate, it is called as average. So it goes on decreasing till laminar stage. In the transition flow, it again increases rapidly. Again, it will be decreasing in turbulent flow. So we cannot take all the values of this H to get the numerical to be solved. So we'll imagine one average value for this entire variation, that is average convection coefficient. Okay. So this H will be speaking about in the numericals. But actually in practical concepts, this is not the case. This is the case. Okay. And now class number 2, we have discussed about Reynolds number. So in class number 3, you need to know about Prandtl number. So what is the Prandtl number in a sense? This Prandtl number is ratio of mu Cp by Ks. It's a dimensionless parameter. Reynolds number gives you the type of flow, and this gives us the relative thickness between delta and delta T, that is velocity boundary layer thickness and thermal boundary layer thickness. So this relative value will be defined with the help of Prandtl number. For example, if the fluid is air, this delta will be equal to delta T for the Prandtl number 1. If it is water, for Prandtl number almost 10, those two will be equal. If it is liquid metals, if Prandtl number is very, very less than 1, then delta T will be very, very greater than delta. Likewise, the relation between these two will be defined with the help of this Prandtl number. Fine. But it also depends on the fluid that you are taking. Okay. These are all the things that you need to analyze while explaining thermal boundary layer. Even in examination, you need to mention all these points. Okay. Fine. I guess this class went for a longer period of time. It's time to wind up. Have a thorough revision. At the first time, it looks like something fishy. Go through it. There is nothing difficulty. Just revise this video for once again. You'll get all the concepts cleared. Entire game lies with dT by dx in thermal boundary layer, and it is dou v by dou y in velocity boundary layer. Here it is dou v by dou y. Dou v by dou y for velocity boundary layer, dT by dy for thermal boundary layer. Thank you.